My name is Dr. Matthew Jameson. I am a professor of musicology. My research largely concerns the temporal phenomenology of music, how we perceive time in music, and the cultural implications of time, nostalgia, timeliness, and timelessness. I commissioned the composition of this suite in order to ask a series of questions. Questions which may or may not become more apparent throughout this introduction and throughout this suite with time. I must say, I was surprised when Will Davenport, the composer, invited me to introduce the work. Often now, I try not to speak, to introduce, to explain my work. Processes such as speaking and breathing, the movement of joints and flexing of muscles seem to burgeon time. You see, even now, the more you become aware of it, divided by breath, by pulse, by skin, an organic calendar, your heart rate increases. So, I simply stop. The benefit of a recorded narration is that you no longer need to breathe. Every word is kept, catalogued, immortalized, long after. Now, first and foremost, listen. We have time allocated for this. Time, which I am afraid to say, you won't get back. Now, imagine you are stood on a line, a timeline which stretches out in front of you. I want you to divide this timeline into five. These five sections amount in total to approximately 18 to 20 minutes, and this time in your life is allocated to this suite. Now imagine the timeline continuing past these five sections, in both directions, both in front and behind you. The irrelevant offcuts of the timeline. We shall call these parts your life. If you were to step backwards on the line, you may step into what you had for lunch yesterday, but you can't. You can only step forwards. You have no choice. You are at one minuscule point of this timeline, constantly moving into the future. This is the time in its absolute mathematical sense. It renders you an atom, a speck, and the timeline unravels even past the offcuts of your life. And we shall call this everything which ever happened and ever will. You keep stepping forward, just one fiber of now holding you together, like dust, and yet you keep moving. Pollen floating through the air, a delicate structure, constantly moving. You are so fragile compared to a river which with time carves out a valley, or a mineral which crystallizes into rock. You are tiny. But of course, the idea of a timeline is a rubbish analogy, because time seems to bifurcate and fracture around you like a network of tiny cracks in the varnish of an ancient oil painting. These cracks form cross-sections of longing, desire, hopes, and dreams. And now, I want you to forget. Because absolute time means absolutely nothing to us. We do not perceive time as something absolute or constant. Instead, we travel, crawling through a rubble of memory, lies, anticipation. Listen, in listening to me, you are navigating the past. Listening and understanding is just remembering. Every word you hear, you are correlating to the previous word and to the previous sentence. You are remembering, piecing together syllables to form something altogether more coherent. What is time? Well, first and foremost, listen. We remember every sound, yet with every sound, every syllable, all meaning has already left us, for every sound is a spectre.